Mr. Speaker, I rise to demand the Vietnamese government immediately release Michael Nguyen, an American citizen and Orange County resident who has been unjustly detained for over 5 months. Michael is a loving husband and father of four, a small business owner and an active member of his community and church. He has no criminal record in the United States. This summer, while visiting elderly relatives, Michael was arrested by the Vietnamese government. He is under investigation for allegedly violating Article 109 of the Vietnamese Criminal Code, activities against the government. Article 109 is an arbitrary and vague charge the Vietnamese government often uses to justify baseless arrests. Michael could be held for months without formal charges as the Vietnamese government investigates. Despite repeated requests by my office, the Vietnamese have yet to produce any evidence substantiating Michael's arrest. These unjust actions are further exacerbated by the Vietnamese government denying Michael's family's request to visit him while in prison. During the investigation, the Vietnamese government only permits monthly visits by the U.S. State Department. These visits are the only opportunity Michael has to hear messages from his loved ones. Mr. Speaker, Michael's family has been devastated by this ordeal. I had the opportunity to meet with them again just this last week when I was back in Orange County, and I'm here tonight on their behalf to echo their calls for his safe return. The Vietnamese government has not only denied an innocent man his freedom, it has completely disrupted the lives of a loving wife, four young daughters, and countless friends and family members across the country who are praying for Michael's homecoming every single day. Michael's wife, Helen, is a nurse who works long hours with many emergency on-call days. During Michael's absence, she has been a single mother to their four young daughters. The girls miss their father dearly. His detainment has made it difficult for them to focus on their schoolwork and their extracurricular activities. These girls should not have to spend one more sleepless night worried about their father's safety. Their entire family has demonstrated incredible strength during this ordeal. I am constantly inspired by their love and devotion to Michael. Mr. Speaker, this unjust detainment has gone on far too long. Michael's detainment is the only most recent example of Vietnam's troubling human rights record and lack of transparent legal system. Earlier this year, the Vietnamese government unjustly detained William Nguyen, an American citizen of no relation to Michael. I am deeply concerned for Michael's safety and well-being, and I demand his release immediately. In the meantime, I call on the Vietnamese government to allow Michael's family to visit him in prison. Mr. Speaker, as you can imagine, this time of year is especially difficult for Michael and his family. While most families across our nation will have the opportunity to spend time together celebrating Christmas, the Nguyen family will cope with Michael's absence. This Christmas, I pray for good news for the Nguyen family. Michael's story has touched so many people. Several of my colleagues have heard of Michael's detainment and have joined in my fight to secure his release. I am grateful for their support and their willingness to join tonight's special order. While I will not be returning to Congress next year, I am confident that my colleagues will continue the fight to bring Michael home. And I'm extremely grateful for my colleagues' engagement, and I will continue to support their efforts any way I can as a